you had something on your phone.
Yeah, it's a gimbal to help me keep it steady.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
That is really cool.
Oh, thank
you.
So
then you can work.
I just have
bigger hands with the small phone.
Yeah, that can keep it steady. So that's
awesome.
I'm not as steady as I used to be.
Yeah, my right hand does this. So I try to do little things and my hand will shake.
Yeah, you can get it probably cheap over in Amazon.
That's awesome. I didn't even know that existed.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
I'll probably have a good day.
You too. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Oh, you got something for Tracy's
Greetings.
Hello, how are we all doing?
Okay.
Thank you.
And the sad thing is the bikes are still better than the one I got.
Yes, this is the bicycle shop. Feel free to look around and let me know if you have any questions. It is also a sporting goods store, so if you're looking for any sporting goods, you can go as well. Yes, and today if you'd like, you can make a political button. So we do have our two candidates for mayor that you can make a button for. Or if you don't like any of those options, you can flip it over and design it.
Do it. Yes. It's very exciting. Bicycle I could break my neck on.
And if you are looking for a copy of the newspaper, our newspaper office is open and we have lots of copies of other times. Really? Is okay? Oh, this is fun. Frankly, I think Judy ought to take that club and clobber a punch over the head with it.
bit of sausage, just a bit past it.
You can go in.
Thank you.
Mr. Grimm, stop trying to scare people. This is the mercantile. Is there anything I can help you find?
I'm good. Thank you.
So if you can't find it here or anywhere in the village, we can order it from the Sears and Roebuck or the Montgomery Ward catalog.
Thank you.
They're on the counter if you'd like to look at them.
Alrighty. Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you. Happy 4th.
Happy 4th.
and the only Miss Ida B. Wells Barnett. All voices be heard.
I am so thankful for being asked to take part in this day's special occasion.
Hello.
Coming to Ohio Village is always a great joy for me. And as you may know, as Ms. Taylor has said, earlier as well, I'm on my way right now from Chicago, Illinois to Washington, D.C., along with a group of gentlemen lawmakers to meet with President William McKinley himself to demand that he take action against the countless atrocities being committed against colored Americans across this country in the form of lynching. I believe he sent those young gentlemen lawmakers so that they could keep me in line. They obviously don't know me very well. More specifically, I plan to bring to President McKinley's attention and implore the president to punish the killers of Frazier Baker and his daughter, Julia. He was South Carolina's newest postmaster and the first colored man to hold that position. They were both shot to death by members of a white mob just the spring of this year.
Tell me,
how can the so-called land of the free be somewhere that allows the lynching and the murder of countless innocent colored people? It is with this same urgency that I speak to you today regarding the position we as a people hold in this country. How can a country that calls itself a world leader be so far behind the others in its dispensing of justice for the innocent? It is not only our duty, but our responsibility to take as much action as I ask our president to take on our own behalf.
Hear,
hear! It is my desire to expose the hypocrisy at the very core of America's vision of itself. I encourage you to work by agitation, education, and advocation for the rights of our people in this country. We are all Americans. Our place is here. We are doctors, soldiers, teachers, lawyers, farmers, lawmakers, and small business owners. Mothers, fathers, sisters, and brothers. We are neighbors who have strong boundaries and care about the future of our land. We are proud to serve to have our voices recognized.
Thank you.
That's a lot of stuff.